just like the Tonight Show, but earlier, when you're all still feeling fresh, and because we've moved our show to an earlier format, that means we are turning to you, pint-sized listeners, to be our celebrity guests. Speaking of guests, let's bring one out right now. Say hello, me Mucky Nuts, to Piper! Hello, Piper, how you doing? Oh, good. I'm happy to hear it. I'm so glad you've joined us from Florida. Piper, tell us, what do you want to do today on the afternoon show? You're out here on the stage, you've hit your mark, and this audience is enthralled. Look at them. They're just looking at you with eyes the size of frying pans. Tell us, Piper, what do you want to do for us?
I want to play the piano.
Whoa, you're going to play the piano for us?
Yeah.
No kidding. Wait, are you sitting at a piano right now, Piper?
No, but I have moved up the levels in piano.
Oh, okay, gotcha. So you're not actually going to play the piano for us, but you're going to talk about how you are a pianist. You've been playing, and you moved up a level. How did you do that? How do you move up a level in piano, Piper? What's the secret?
You have to get really good at the first level, and then you get to the staff.
Oh, I see. Okay, and what?
No.
And what does it mean to get really good at the first level? Does that mean that you have to be able to stand on the piano and do a backflip and then, like, stick it? Like, land on both feet with your arms high enough, sort of like gymnastics? Is that how you move to the next level?
No. You move to the next level by keeping your fingers down on the piano while you play. And that's something I had really...
Oh, I see. Oh, got it. Okay, so you moved to the next level of piano simply by becoming a better piano player, but you said you had trouble with it, so it took a lot of practice. Like, how hard did you practice to move up? Like, how hard would you say that you worked?
I went to my piano teacher once every week.
Once a week, okay. And did you practice in between those sessions with your piano teacher? Did you practice at home?
Yes. I have a keyboard at home.
Got it. Okay. And, like, when you were working, like, on your keyboard at home and you were practicing something and you made a mistake, what did you do when making a mistake? Did you, like, run around the house screaming, like, throwing pots and pans all over the floor and then trying again? Or what was your reaction if you made a mistake while you went?
So I always, like, you know when you can't talk, and you just correct yourself by doing with your tongue.
Oh, yeah, right, yeah, I know.
That's what I do, and I tell myself, my fingers can't work today.
I see, okay, so you just go, blah, 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 just shake it out a little bit, and then try again. Your fingers obviously are the problem, so you just shake those things out, try again, and each time it just gets a little bit better. That's the secret.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I should try that. I record music a lot. I play music a lot at live shows, and I record it too when I make my own music. And when I make a mistake, here's my strategy. I go down to the kitchen, and I get a gallon of milk out of the fridge, like a full gallon of milk, and I open it up over my head and just pour the whole milk over me until I'm totally soaked with milk, and then I come back upstairs and try again. Would you say that's another good way to get better at playing an instrument, Piper? Or do you think your way is better?
Yes.
Okay. That's certainly it's a good way to go through a lot of milk. Man, they think that we're just drinking it hand over fist here at the Monkey House. We should call it the Milky House. So, Piper, now that you're at the new level in piano, are you playing songs?
I have been playing songs, but I'm on better songs.
Oh, the songs are getting better. So you went from, I don't know, like playing Coldplay songs, now you're playing like Billy Joel songs?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I've also been playing, like, songs by Beethoven, like,
Oh, man. Yeah, Beethoven was, like, the Billy Joel of his generation. Now, Ode to Joy, that's a classic. Have you mastered that one yet, or are you still working on it, Piper?
I have mastered it.
You've mastered it. Oh, good. I was going to suggest you go down to the kitchen and pour the milk over your head, but you've already made it there. Audience, give it up for Piper in Florida, who's already moved up in piano.
Okay.